Hello and welcome to our review for the first game of the Indian T20 League. My name is Akhil. I have my friend and colleague Arun, and welcome to Time Out with Sports Adda. Hi Arun, all excited for the first game?
Yeah, Kel, two more days, one sleep left, as they say in Australia. Can't wait. And what a bumper opening we've got. It's Mumbai against Bangalore.
Absolutely, two big teams starting out. I mean, the anxiety levels for the first games are of a different kind, I guess. Everybody's just waiting to see how everybody comes in after a little bit of break. It's not a huge cricketing break for them, but coming together as a team after almost say 5 6 months, and it's always exciting. The gear is fresh, everybody is like looking forward to how they turn up.
And you can have hours and hours of practice, but getting on a
Exactly.
racetrack, or in this case, getting onto a cricket field, and remember, it's only 20 overs, so to perform at your optimal level in those 20 overs or 40 overs in a match is going to be a big ask. People don't realize it, but it's a huge ask. It's like you're thrust in a kitchen and given 20 minutes to make a dish. It's like all these master chefs and cutthroat kitchens and all that. The pressure is immense on these guys.
True, very true. So what are your insights about starting 11s maybe? Like, do you have any thoughts on the starting 11s of both the teams?
I'm pretty much certain that Mumbai know what the 11 are. Even there might be a question mark about one place, but I'm pretty much sure that they're going to stick to most of it. The question mark I said was against Nathan Coulter-Nile, but there's Adam Milne as an option for that position, but I'd still go with Nathan Coulter-Nile. Adam Milne hasn't been in great wicket taking form in T20 cricket recently, but yeah, otherwise I think Mumbai look a settled side, and I'd be surprised if they don't make the playoffs. With this kind of a side, which has been there, done that for at least a couple of seasons. Trent Bolt came in last year, but other than that, if you look at it, all the players have been with them for a while now. So I'd be surprised if they don't win, but it'll be a shock if they don't make it to the playoffs.
Right. Will Quinton be playing the first game? Because he's also just come in after the second ODI. And I don't know the quarantine. They have not announced anything about him. But I heard about the two Delhi fast bowlers being in quarantine, and they might be missing the first game. So we might be in for a surprise, but Quinton might not be playing. Maybe. I'm not sure of the policy there.
Yeah, I haven't read anything or I haven't picked up anything on social media from any of these teams. We've only known of their arrivals in India and they've joined the bubble and all those kind of news. But assuming that Quinton's available, I think he should certainly start the first game.
Yeah, solid team. Solid team they have built together. Moving
Absolutely.
on to the Bangalore team. Bangalore team. We discussed the four foreign players last time.
Oh man, you just keep looking at stuff. You just try to figure out Bangalore's 11, and first there was news of Devdutt Padikkal missing out. Hence, we've got a question mark against his name. Then we don't know who's batting at number six. I think number seven, number eight. There was Daniel Sams had penciled in, but he's tested positive, and now he's out of the
Unfortunately, yeah.
reckoning for the. Yeah, very unfortunate. So who are the 11? Like, do Bangalore know the 11? What are your thoughts? Who's going to open? I mean, we've seen a lot of scores from these two practice matches, intra squad practice matches they've had. So who do you think is
Yeah.
going to open?
I think they might go for one of the young guns, maybe a Sachin baby, somebody who might just give them a flying start with Virat at the beginning. He might just go full bonkers. I had like a very I read somewhere it might be a good idea to try Washington Sundar at the top also, because he's shown that he can really bat well. He has all the technique, and for a 20 over, like how Sunil Narayan was effectively used by the Kolkata team, Sundar can easily fit into that role in a T20 game, and with Virat at the other end, it's always beneficial. Both of them can just go hammer and tongs, and it might just be a game changer for them. I don't know if they might try it.
But you've also got to take into consideration the men who will be running into bowl to them. There's Jasprit Bumrah, who might get a one over.
Wow.
There's Trent Bolt, who's a magician with the new ball, even if it's just for one or two overs. But it's going to be a huge challenge. The way I see it, I think Mohammad Azharuddin is a good chance to open.
Yeah.
There's talks about Rajat Pattidar also.
So but if, like if, the practice games, right?
Correct. Correct, yeah. So if anything, I think the team could be leaning at Mohammad Azharuddin more, but we'll see what the team decides to pick. Question marks, I say.
Yeah, I had a very interesting question actually, because both the teams and both the captains have been falling to a lot of spinners in the last couple of years. And do you think it might be a strategy again by both the teams, both the captains are going to open? So do you think Rahul Chahar or Yuzvendra Chahal will open for both the teams, open the bowling?
It's a tempting option, Akhil. It's definitely a tempting option. But, you know, look at what resources they've got, RCB in particular. What resources do they have in the middle? You know, if you see RCB, Virat Kohli likes to open one end with Washington Sundar, who's more like a dart kind of a bowler, wicket to wicket, keeps it straight, no variation in flight, nothing, makes it difficult to hit. So Washington Sundar at one end, and if you get Chahal as well, then who's going to bowl your middle overs? You know, that's a problem that Virat Kohli has got, not so much Rohit Sharma. Rohit can still take that, you know, gamble and say, let's open one end with Rahul Chahar. But then why? If you've got somebody like a Trent Bolt, who's a magician, like I said, if you've got Jasprit Bumrah, I wouldn't necessarily subscribe to this.
Mm-hmm. Bumrah's matchups against the Bangalore batsman is quite good. They had like a lot of success.
Mouth-watering, isn't it? You know, outstanding. I want to watch. This is the matchup that I'm looking for. You know, Jasprit Bumrah bowling to a Virat Kohli, AB de Villiers and Glenn Maxwell. You know, don't be surprised if you see Bumrah last year, remember, was used a lot in the middle overs. But if Virat Kohli is opening tomorrow, I wouldn't be surprised if Jasprit Bumrah is given the new ball straight away. So his matchups against Virat Kohli, AB de Villiers and Maxwell, he's had a lot of success against all these three. And that presents a mouth-watering contest for me.
Yeah, absolutely. I had a chance to have a long chat with Bumrah a couple of years ago. Virat was actually his first wicket in the league.
I was there too. Played. I was there when we did that interview.
And I had a long chat about how he plots about getting him out. And I mean, that was quite a couple of years ago, actually. But he is a very, very thoughtful bowler. Also, very interesting insight he gave that the moment he sees somebody like an AB de Villiers in the league, him and Krunal also. Krunal also had a long chat about this. So, Krunal has dismissed AB quite a number of times. So, both of them said that they face a lot of abuse on social media after they dismiss AB de Villiers and they celebrated a couple of times. That's the kind of love that de Villiers had, that even if an Indian player dismisses him, they get trolled on social media.
That's the power of social media, isn't it? You call it power, or you call it that. That's the bad side to the negative side to it. I mean, there's love. There's a lot of love on social media. There's no denying that. But you know, where there's love, where there's good, there's bad. You know, as they say. So you know, you've got to be prepared for it. And AB de Villiers is so dear to Bangalore fans. I don't think I've ever seen AB de Villiers angry. You know, he brings a lot of energy. He's always carrying putting a smile on his face. So he's a lovable personality. Absolutely
total
lovable.
Respect.
Yeah, absolutely.
What about the matchups for the RCB, for the Bangalore bowlers versus the Mumbai batsmen? Who do you think are looking forward there?
Chahal. Now, you know, RCB have got a decent pace attack. There's Saini, Siraj, and, you know, Mumbai's powerhouse is their middle order, right? You know, look at Hardik, Kyron Pollard, Krunal, maybe even Surya before that. So, given the most dangerous batsmen are Hardik and Pollard, I'm looking at their matchups against Chahal. He's the smartest leg spinner I've seen, you know, in the Indian T20 league. His numbers have been, his form's not been great recently. But look at that against Pollard. You know, four dismissals in 43 balls rather. He's gone for a few runs, yes, but you know, if you can get the big wicket of Pollard, it limits the damage, as they say. Same with Rohit Sharma and Hardik Pandya. You know, he's got their numbers. He might not have picked them up too often, but you know, he obviously has got some tricks up his sleeve to limit their run scoring ability. So that's the matchup I'm looking for. Yujvendra Chahal bowling to Hardik Pandya and Karan Pollard.
Interesting. Yeah, I mean, Yuzvendra Chahal is extremely close to Rohit, and they hang around a lot also outside the field. So he's always wanting to get Rohit out of the field and just put it up on social media and show that he's got him out. But I'm also excited to see Mohammad Siraj now. He's last year, if you remember, he picked up three or four wickets in a game and won them a match on his own. And now he's coming back after a very successful couple of months where he's emerged as a wicket-taking bowler. So his confidence must be very high. If they use him well, he might just give them a couple more games.
That's the key, Akhil. The key you mentioned there is use him smartly, use him well. Often, bowlers are just throwing the ball, but it's also about the captain getting the best out of you, which is where Rohit Sharma as a captain is outstanding. You know, say what you want, I've said, but I love Rohit Sharma as a captain. He gets the best out of his team. Look at what he's done to the Pandya brother. Look at what he's done with Jasprit Bumrah. They're natural talent, yes, but you've got to harness their talent. That's where Rohit Sharma's done it. And, you know, if Virat Kohli is able to do that with Saini and Washington Sundar, brilliant. Just talking about, you know, the captaincy record, Akhil, where do you stand? You know, Rohit the better captain or Virat the better captain? You obviously know who I rate higher.
I mean, obviously, Rohit has put together a formidable, formidable record in T20s. I don't think there is anybody who can match up to the kind of tournament victories that he has had. And obviously, he's also not found it easy. You know, when he took over the captaincy at Mumbai, it was not as if they were winning everything or they were putting together a dominating team.
Middle of a season, wasn't it?
Middle of a season with Ricky Ponting backing out. So, what he's come in and he's got a good support system around him also, which we cannot deny. The team has found a way to win games. They've found a way to win tournaments. So that structure has remained for Rohit, a nice strong structure. That has not remained for Virat. If you see in the background, the amount of coaches who've come and gone there, the kind of support staff who've come and gone there. So there's always been instability. But Rohit, I mean, I love his captaincy. I love his batting. I love his language style. I've also had a chance to meet him a couple of times during the tournament. Before the games or anything, you won't feel that this guy is going to come and lead a side in the next couple of days on the field. He's so chilled out. He knows the team is sorted now. He's in a very good mind space. So I always look forward to watching how he leads.
It's like two completely contrasting personalities, isn't it? One is, you know, all pumped up, hyper, body language, attitude in your face all the time. That's Virat Kohli, obviously. And on the other side is Rohit Sharma, who's chalta hai bido, chalna. You know, that kind of attitude, you know, laid back, you know, no pressure. I mean, no pressure on the shoulders, so to say, but, you know, obviously there's a lot riding, but you can't look at him and say, you know, this guy's preparing for a match or this guy's the captain of a side, you know. That personality is completely different.
No, it's an absolute pleasure watching Rohit bat. I hope he goes aggressively. Like the last couple of T20 games that he played for India, if you saw, he was batting really aggressively when he opened with Virat in that third match. So I really hope he bats like that for the Mumbai team also, because he has a lot of firepower down the order. So that Rohit Sharma is absolutely special to watch. Very like goes after the bowler. That's going to be fun now.
Absolutely, you know, can't disagree with you there. Just want to pick your thoughts, Akhil, since you're more into brands and, you know, commercials and all of that. I picked up this interesting tweet yesterday. RCB posted something about Virat Kohli, where it said, "I don't see myself leaving or playing for any other IPL team. Home is where the heart is," with a picture of Virat Kohli. I want to understand, Akhil, you know, it's troubled me a lot. You know, in this era of, you know, where results and commercials are bigger than anything else, or how is it that Virat Kohli continues to remain with RCB despite not winning them a title? What I mean, and he's got the backing of the franchisee, as we see here.
Well, he's a special guy. He's a special cricketer. So obviously, he's also somebody who's the pivot for the team. He's been with them since the first season, and the way he's developed as a player, the entire team. He's like the core for the team. A lot of brands that the team would also be getting would be because of Virat association. Obviously, every brand cannot reach out to him individually and sign him on. So with the league happening and him being such an integral part for the team, it's a nice way for brands to come and associate with him, use him tactically for these 2-3 months. And obviously, if they win, that's a huge bonus, because Bangalore sports fans are just outstanding. The social media fans and the kind of support that the Bangalore franchisee gets, and not just the cricket team but the other teams also, it's just mind-blowing. They really love their sport. They cheer the team through thick and thin. And obviously, Virat is a special case. If you've seen, MS is also, MS Dhoni, he stayed with Chennai for the longest. I don't think Rohit is also going to leave Mumbai now. I mean, he's the core. So these guys are all like the core spectrums of each of the teams. So I think that's something. And it's a nice statement for Virat also to make. It shows loyalty to the franchisee. It shows that he's ready to be with them through thick and thin.
The difference, to Akhil, you mentioned a couple of other names there. Rohit and MS Dhoni, they've won titles. They've been immensely successful. Virat Kohli, not so much. But yeah, I mean, that's a relationship between the franchisee and the player. So I mean, it's just one of the things that's troubled me in the past. Looking at it, tomorrow's game, playing in Chennai, it's an opener. They're playing in Chennai. In Chennai, who are you picking to win?
I think Mumbai have been. I mean, while they've done well at Chennai, I just think they've always been slow starters. Last year also, I think they lost first game. So, I mean, according to that stat, I would say that let's go with Bangalore for tomorrow. Even, I mean, their spinners are also going to come into play. Chahal and Washington Sundar both have been playing cricket recently. So, I think let's go with Bangalore for tomorrow in terms of the first game.
I'm going with Mumbai. I think there's something about Mumbai again this season. Two things before we wrap up. One is Mumbai are on a 5-match winning streak in Chennai. Bangalore are on a 5-match losing streak in Chennai. So one of that streaks has got to break tomorrow. So I still think Mumbai will make it 6 wins in a row. Also, second thing, you know, why I say Mumbai are favorites to start well. Is look at the opponents they've got now. They've got Bangalore, obviously, first. And then they've got Kolkata, if I remember correctly, the next game. And against both these teams, they've got a very favorable record. If I were to just read out a couple of numbers before we wrap. Until 2014, the head-to-head between Mumbai and Bangalore was 8-7 in favor of Mumbai. So 8-7, right? Mm-hmm. Since 2015, it's 9-3.
Wow.
So Mumbai for me tomorrow. Akhil thinks Bangalore. We'll see where this goes, how this goes. Join us tomorrow for a recap of the match, and then we'll also preview tomorrow's game. Speak to you then. See you. Bye.
Bye-bye.